Evidence is mounting that the problems with Obamacare go beyond just the difficulties with the website. Many Americans are losing their insurance, and others are finding that the cost of insurance is much higher.
Congress is trying to find out just what did go wrong with the rollout of Obamacare Online. Ephraim Graham has the story.
Democrats and Republicans on the House Energy Committee agree the rollout of healthcare.gov has been profoundly flawed.
This is unacceptable. It needs to be fixed.
Amazon and eBay don't crash the week before Christmas.
How can the administration punish innocent Americans by forcing them to buy from a system that does not work and whose rollout has been nothing short of a disaster?
Republicans on the committee accused the administration of misleading Congress prior to the rollout.
We were repeatedly told by members of the administration that everything would be working properly and it would all be done on time.
Software contractors insisted they did their part, but that the administration did not allow enough time for developing or testing the site. Secretary of Health and Human Services Kathleen Sebelius said she's calling up the reserves, hoping for a quick fix to an ailing system.
We've looked across the federal government at some of the best tech experts who weren't necessarily on the ground working on this project, but are now involved.
Some Democrats now say the administration should extend the deadline for signing up and revise the penalties for those who don't enroll. Another worry? It's now clear. Many Americans are finding their health insurance premiums have shot up. And Kaiser Health News reports hundreds of thousands have received cancellation notices, despite the president's original promise people could keep their plans. Democrats who thought they'd run for re-election next year, touting the success of Obamacare, now are starting to worry about the political fallout. As Republicans point out, the website failures could simply be a sign of more problems to come.
I'm also concerned about what happens next. Will enrollment glitches become provider payment glitches? Will patients show up at their doctor's office or hospital to be told that maybe they aren't covered or even in the system?
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
And the Obama administration is facing yet another political headache, this time over the National Security Agency's international surveillance programs. John Jessup has that story from our news bureau in Washington. John?
Gordon, European leaders are promising to keep up a strong relationship with the United States, this despite their anger at the latest allegations of widespread U.S. spying on its allies. The leaders are meeting at an EU summit in Brussels, and they want new rules on surveillance by the end of the year. German Chancellor Angela Merkel is the alleged target in this latest controversy, with reports the National Security Agency may have listened in on her cell phone conversations. Merkel said this shattered her trust in the U.S. and undermined the transatlantic relationship. President Obama spoke with Chancellor Merkel by phone to assure her the U.S. is not listening to her calls now.
I just think it's bureaucracy out of control. I mean, once you start to have this capability, you start to use it without really thinking about what you're doing. And I do think here's a case where the NSA has just gotten completely out of control. I think it's very important that the president rein this in as quickly as possible.
The White House soon may be facing other angry heads of state as well. The British newspaper The Guardian says it obtained a confidential memo suggesting the NSA was able to monitor 35 world leaders' communication in 2006. The U.S. Air Force Academy may drop a religious reference from an oath that cadets take to swear allegiance to the school's honor code. The Military Religious Freedom Foundation says the phrase, "So help me God," at the end of the oath is unconstitutional and has threatened to sue the Academy if the phrase isn't removed. The Colorado Springs Gazette reports the Academy is considering several options, including dumping the entire oath or making the religious reference optional. But religious freedom attorneys, including Jay Sekulow of the American Center for Law and Justice, say the phrase does not violate the Constitution. Well, this summer, one of the nation's largest school districts shut down a controversial program that tracks students using radio frequency technology. Its chief opponent, a 16-year-old student. Heather Sells has this update on her story and what it means for schools around the country.
It's kind of like a dream. You hoped it would happen, but you never thought it would. And when it did, you're just like, awesome.
Andrea Hernandez took on the Northside Independent School District, the largest in South Texas with more than 100,000 students, and she won. At issue, this tracking device, also known as a school ID badge. Its tiny batteries emit radio waves that allow a school to locate a student's exact location at any point in the day.
It's not just knowing the schedule of a student, which may or may not hold true for that day, but it's actually knowing physically where that child is.
But for Hernandez, the badge meant a violation of her faith, lining up with what she read in Revelation about the mark of the beast.
You couldn't be in the school without having the chip, and you know, you couldn't buy lunch, you couldn't vote for homecoming, you couldn't do all the stuff that a normal student would do unless you had this tracking chip. Just like in the Bible, you can't buy, sell, or trade unless you have the mark.
Hernandez paid a high price for her protest. When it became clear that she would not wear the RFID badge, her magnet high school expelled her.
And they said that they would be dropping me from the rosters that day, or the following day.
So what caused Northside to switch gears and drop the $250,000 program? Spokesman Gonzalez said it came down to money. Northside had hoped the RFID badges would allow it to better track and count extra students for attendance, bringing it more in state funds. But in the end, attendance barely increased at its two pilot schools, bumping up by less than 1%. What happened in San Antonio may slow down the movement to put RFID technology in schools across the country. That's good news for privacy advocates and for Hernandez, who is back and ready to enjoy school.
RFID being gone is a huge weight lifted off my shoulders. It's good to go back and just be a student. And it's good to not have to worry about tracking and all this radiation floating around the school.
Reporting in San Antonio, Heather Sells, CBN News.
Iran could be just a month or so away from building a nuclear bomb. A new report from the U.S. Institute for Science and International Security says Iran could make enough weapons-grade uranium to make a bomb by then. The report says the new findings have implications for any negotiations with Iran over its nuclear program. Iran is currently involved in international talks. The U.S. and other countries, like Israel, believe it wants to build a nuclear weapon, a charge that Iran denies. A court in Iran has sentenced four Christians to 80 lashes each for drinking wine during a communion service. Christian Solidarity Worldwide reports the verdict was handed down in the Iranian city of Rasht on Monday, and the Christians have 10 days to appeal. Iran has put numerous Christians in prison, including American pastor Saeed Abedini, imprisoned on charges related to his Christian faith. The American Center for Law and Justice has launched a letter-writing campaign for his release, and you can find out more about that by going to our website at cbnnews.com. Evangelist Billy Graham is now home from the hospital. He was admitted earlier this week for pulmonary tests and was released Thursday night. A spokesman said he was alert the whole time and did not have any problems with the scheduled tests. Franklin Graham says his father has round-the-clock care and still thinks and speaks very clearly. Several people in his community in North Carolina have shown their love and support by praying for Graham.
Prayers are he stays healthy, and with this upcoming, his last message that he's going to put out coming up in November, we're looking forward to that.
You can find out more about Billy Graham's upcoming series of videos called My Hope America by going to myhopewithbillygraham.org. You can also get that link by going to cbnnews.com.
Texas A&M University plans to open a campus in the northern Israeli city of Nazareth, the boyhood home of Jesus. It is the first time a leading American university intends to open a branch in Israel. Dubbed a Peace University, will be located in Israel's largest Arab city. That city also has the biggest Arab Christian population.
The state of Israel and the state of Texas share a deep respect for our cultures, and this university will be a permanent reminder of the power of education to change the lives of people forever, in line with the vision of our governor.
A&M System Chancellor John Sharp says the staff will be Jewish and Arab, and the student body will be diverse. Texas A&M says it will raise $70 million for construction of that new campus. Operation Blessing is providing clean drinking water to a village in Laos. Teams drilled a well, giving families a way to access clean water at any time for cooking, cleaning, bathing, and even watering gardens. Villagers used to spend hours retrieving water, leaving no extra time for work. One woman said of the new well, quote, "My life and my family have become better because of having clean water from the well near our house." This is now one of five wells in the region that provides clean drinking water for villagers. You can find out more about Operation Blessing by going to its website, ob.org.